Hello, I'm Sean Servas from FEMA headquarters. Welcome to Module 2, Organization Management. This module will focus, obviously, on organization management. Now we're ready to start Module 2. We're going to look into FEMA Go and go over organizations and how to add team members and give them roles within that organization. At the end of this module, you'll be able to describe the FEMA Go registration process, explain how to log in to FEMA Go, recognize how organizations and suborganizations relate in FEMA Go, explain how to add a team member and assign roles, explain how to add a suborganization and assign user roles for members of the suborganization, and finally, recognize the information in a FEMA Go user profile. The first step for an organization authorized representative is to register for a FEMA Go account. Within FEMA's new grants management system, there is a new registration process. For those users who already have a SAM.gov account, the process is streamlined. Your SAM.gov account information will transfer when you set up an account in FEMA Go. For communities that have not applied for federal assistance before, it is a three-step process. You'll first need to create a login.gov account, then create a SAM.gov account, then you can request access to FEMA Go to set up your account. Communities that do not have a SAM.gov account can also be registered to access FEMA Go by their applicant organizations by adding the suborganization manually. Let's take a quick look at the FEMA Go website. So when you first go to go.fema.gov, you'll be presented with this screen. You can either log in or create an account. Creating an account is really easy. It's just like signing up for any web page. And that's the most simple part of the process. Joining an organization or a suborganization is a little bit more complicated and requires more steps. And we'll get into those in the next slides. Once you click on that create an account button, you'll be presented to enter your email address. And after filling out the required information, you'll be sent a confirmation link to approve your account. And then you'll be asked to enter your name and your password. You can only reset your password once in 24 hours. So if you forget your password on the last day or potentially next to last day of the application period, you'll not be able to submit the subapplication or application. The last step is to log in to FEMA Go. After you've created your account, you enter your email address and the password that you've chosen and click log in. If you're a brand new user to FEMA Go and you don't have any roles, the only thing that you'll be presented with when you log in for the first time is the ability to search for your organization point of contact. So if you enter your DUNS number, you'll be presented with two different points of contact, your default authorized organization representatives. One is your SAM.gov electronic business point of contact, and the other is your SAM.gov government business point of contact. FEMA Go automatically pulls that information from SAM.gov, and you could contact one of those individuals and ask them to add you to your organization, or you could ask another authorized organization representative to add you to that organization. Within the Hazard Mitigation Assistance Grant programs, there is a relationship between applicants, subapplicants, and FEMA. FEMA provides financial assistance through grants to a state, Indian tribe, or territorial government. The states, tribes, and territories are called applicants because they apply for the grant funds. States, tribes, and territories create applications with one or more subapplications. Applicants can create subapplications for their own projects, and local communities can also submit subapplications to the applicants to possibly be included in a grant application. If FEMA approves a subapplication, the applicant can do the work directly, or if it was from a subapplicant, it can pass the funds to the local community. Once an award is granted, the applicant will become a recipient, and the subapplicant will become the subrecipient. So in the case of states, generally, and territories, generally, the money is disseminated to their subrecipients. If you're a federally recognized Indian tribe, your subapplications are most likely going to be managed by the grant applicant. who is also the subapplicant. In the legacy system, we used to call that the grantee acting as subgrantee. There are 8 different roles you may have in FEMA Go. At the organization level, there is grant writer, which is the most basic level of permissions, all the way to authorized organization representative, which has the most permissions. You only need one of these roles. If you have authorized organization representative rights or roles, then you have all of the smaller roles permissions already in your account. So you don't need to be an authorized organization representative and a financial member. You already have those permissions as the authorized organization representative. At the sub-organization or sub-applicant level, there are only 2 roles available: subrecipient member and subrecipient authorized representative. The big difference here is the subrecipient authorized representative can submit a sub-application to the grant applicant. A subrecipient member cannot. Same thing goes for the organization level roles. The authorized organization representative is the only role that allows that entity to submit the grant application to FEMA. As I mentioned in the previous slide, in an organization, the AOR is the only user that can sign and submit a grant application. The AOR is also the only person that can manage user access to suborganizations in FEMA Go. At the sub-applicant level, this role is called the sub-applicant authorized representative, or SAR. The SAR manages the sub-applicant user access to their suborganization and can submit their sub-applications. All other suborganization FEMA Go users get the role of subrecipient member, and they can only create, view, and edit a sub-application. At the applicant level, the grant writer is basically the only role that can create a management cost or other type of sub-application, or work on and create a grant application. Organizations can have organization members and grant writers who create, view, and edit a sub-application. Organizations can also have programmatic members who can submit amendments and quarterly program reports, and financial members who can submit amendments and payments, drawdown requests, and quarterly financial reports. And it should be pointed out on this slide that if you're working on sub-applications, even at the organization level, you'll also need a sub-organization role. So you'll need an organization level role and a sub-organization role to be able to work on sub-applications. So let's say you're a federally recognized Indian tribe and you're going to be preparing the sub-application and the grant application for your tribe, then you would want to have the authorized organization representative role as well as the subrecipient authorized representative role. As I mentioned in an earlier slide, the default authorized organization representatives are automatically recognized in FEMA Go based on their position as the electronic business point of contact or government business point of contact in SAM.gov. State and tribal organizations will need to have a discussion with their mitigation staffs about adding team members to FEMA Go and the roles that they should have. If someone on the mitigation staff will be creating sub-applications on behalf of the state or tribe, they will need the role of subrecipient authorized representative. Now I'm going to go through some screenshots of how an authorized organization representative can add the role of subrecipient authorized representative to their profile. So from the authorized organization representative's homepage, where you would click on FEMA Go to get to that, you'll click on organizations, and then you'll click on manage my team, and then you will manage the user that needs the additional role of subrecipient authorized representative. Once you're managing that user or yourself, there'll be a drop down to add those roles. So let's take a look at that in FEMA Go. So like I said, you would go to My Organizations, Manage My Team, and then look for the individual that you wanted to add subrecipient authorized representative to and click Manage. Then you would add another role. And remember, like I said, you have organization level roles and sub-organization level roles. If you're going to be working on and submitting a sub-application, you're going to need this SAR role. Then it'll ask you who the parent organization is, In this case, it's going to be Oklahoma Tribe. That's my only choice. And I know that I want that person to have access to all hazard mitigation assistance grant programs. So I'll just click all, or you can select them individually if you only want them to work on one. Then you scroll all the way to the bottom and hit save and close. And now we can see that that individual has two roles instead of just the one that it had originally. An authorized organization representative will also need to add local governments as suborganizations so they can create and submit subapplications to the grant recipient. So let's say that you're a state. In this case, on the screenshot, we have Tennessee Emergency Management, and they have a suborganization for Tennessee County number one. So let's go take a look at that in FEMA Go as well. So similar to managing the organization, you can also manage your suborganizations. So if I click on suborganizations, I can add a suborganization, but I need to know their DUNS number to be able to add that suborganization. So I'm going to click on this link, add a suborganization, and I'm going to reuse the DUNS number that I had just copied. And now FEMA Go, since it has pulled this information automatically from SAM.gov, it recognizes that Oklahoma County number 6 is a valid entity, and it asks me if I would like to add that entity. If that entity is not recognized, you'll be presented with an option to manually add that entity. So then you can assign any or all of the hazard mitigation assistance grant programs to the suborganization, and you'll get a confirmation message. So now we can see that Oklahoma County number 6 has been added as a suborganization, and you can begin adding suborganization team members to that suborganization. And you would do that by managing user access and adding a new user. If there's no one in this drop-down menu, that means that no one from that suborganization has created an account in FEMA Go, so they can't be discovered. If that's the case, it will give you the opportunity to add them as a suborganization member, and then they'll be prompted to register in FEMA Go. Okay, now that we've received the confirmation message that Oklahoma County number 6 has been added to our suborganizations, here I've returned to the My Suborganization list, and we can see that Oklahoma County number 6 is listed as an available suborganization. So now the next step is to add a team member to the suborganization. To do that, I'm going to manage the suborganization. I'm going to click on Manage User Access, and I'm going to add a new user. If a user has registered with FEMA Go, they will appear in this list if they're a member of Oklahoma County number 6. And by default, the electronic business point of contact or the government business point of contact for that organization will be available to be added as a user. So now I'm going to choose the subrecipient authorized representative role. And since I'm in the test environment, this isn't working correctly right now, so I'm going to refer to this screenshot. This is what you should see in the production environment when everything's working correctly. When you click subrecipient authorized representative, you'll be presented with all of the different hazard mitigation assistance grant programs, and you can select all of them choosing this checkbox up here, or you can select the programs individually that you would like that user to have access to. And then once you have selected that, the Add This User button will become activated, and you'll get a confirmation message. The next step is to update your organization and personal FEMA Go profiles. This is important because it will list your contact information, and your phone number is required at the time that you submit your subapplication or grant application. And if you don't have a phone number attached to your profile on the very last page when you're submitting, you have to jump through a bunch of hoops to continue submitting your application. So you want to take care of that before you get to the end of the process and have to do some work over again that you've already done before. So when you're in FEMA Go, you can go to your profile and you can see that there's a button here to add your phone number. So take a minute to take that step to add your phone number to your profile well before you get to the point where you're going to submit your subapplication or grant application. Let's take a minute to go over what we've covered today. By now, you should be able to describe the FEMA Go registration process, explain how to log into FEMA Go, recognize how organizations and suborganizations relate in FEMA Go, explain how to add a team member and assign roles to that team member, explain how to add a suborganization and assign user roles to suborganization members, and finally, recognize the information in a FEMA Go user profile. Here are some resources that will be helpful if you want a refresher on what we've covered today. If you go to GSA's login.gov, you can create your login account for using the system for award management. There's also a link here to SAM.gov, where you'll need to have a SAM.gov account, which your organization probably already does if they've ever applied for federal assistance before. And finally, there's a link to the FEMA Go user registration and login desktop reference, which is also available through FEMA.gov/brick if you want to get into it that way. And you can also refer to the FEMA Go user manual from the same link. Thank you for joining me today for Module 2, and please be sure to join me for Module 3, Subapplication Review. Thank you.